The UI engine is a development environment for creating and documenting websites and web apps. It offers the tooling for generating a pattern library or design system documentation. It also helps you to prototype your components and pages. In this video, I'll guide you through the setup and we'll create a demo application by following the quick start tutorial. We will copy the first line to set up a new folder in which the project will reside. We also initialize an empty project inside of this folder. The next step is to install the project's dependencies. Once the dependencies are installed, we can initialize the UI engine project using the demo flag, so we don't have to start with an empty project. Now that everything is in place, let's go ahead and build the project so that we can have a look at it in the browser and see what it looks like in practice. The homepage of the demo contains some useful content which explains how to create components, variants, and what the next steps might be. On the left, there's the navigation containing the documentation pages, like for instance, the app's colors, the fonts that are used, and the spaces that are utilized in the CSS. The pattern library contains the components. For example, there are some basic elements like a heading component, copy text, a button using two variants, a primary and a secondary button, and we also have an image component. And then there's the demo teaser, which assembles all of these basic elements into a higher level component. The components get rendered inside an iframe. This allows you to toggle the breakpoints you configured. You can also use the viewport mode, which shows all of the configured viewports at once. This is especially helpful if you are developing a responsive website. Next to the preview tab, there's also the code view, which you can use to see the data the component gets rendered with. Using this icon, you can open the component in a separate browser window. The fact that each component is rendered on a separate HTML page is in particular useful for testing. For instance, you can use these pages to automate your visual regression or responsive tests. All right, as I try to keep these videos as short as possible, we'll have a look at the code of the demo project inside an editor in the next video.